Hi guys, Domingo here. Some comment on the test that I was doing in the previous video. I was testing the cooling system, the propulsion, and the rudder. And everything was working fine, but the propeller was generating so much water flow that was hitting the back wall, and the water was returning inside the hole, and here where inside the body is and everything. So I canceled the test, but the test was successful. The water was flowing inside the cooling system, and I was cooling the components, and the rudder was working fine. On this video, I want to show you the progress so far. Starting with the base of the hoop, I used some 2x4s, plywood. I'm using these templates for the bolt heads. I did all the cooling for this piece plywood, and this is the assembly. Continuing with the hood, I painted in white inside to improve visibility. And also I installed the servos for the sail control, and I glued this piece of wood to add as an anchor for the handrails and for the rigging part. I used this aluminum L shape and these screws to be the anchors for the rigging part. Let's assemble the electronic components and test it. This is a rudder control. And it's working fine. And it's mapped here to the rudder. On the radio. This is one of the sails windows. And it has that spring there to maintain the tension. And using these pulleys, it creates a path of pull and push that will control the sails. And in these nuts, I'm going to attach the control lines that are going to go up the deck and connected to the sails. This is the front winch, and it's connected to this, it's mapped to this potentiometer here on the radio. So it will control the other sail. Here you can check the movement. And the movement of the map. Finally, this is the engine. Connected here to the propeller of the boat. And it's really powerful. Some batteries. And that is for the radio control system. This is the deck, and it fits nicely in top of the hook. I create the access
for the cell, one of the cell servos. This is the hatch. I create this design of a rail, so I can apply silicone on the bottom, and then with this lid, it will create a seal, so the water, to prevent the water entering in the hood. Also, I filled and sanded and primed all the deck, so I repaired all the imperfections that you saw on the previous video. And this is also a hatch here for the second servo cell and the rudder servo. I will use this rubber to create like a sealed band, and then with screws I go to this one here, and since this is wood, is going to create like a wood finish floor. I'm going to carve some chips here, and I think it's going to look pretty nice. Here you can see the details for the handrails. I use brad rods, and the process that I did for create this part was 3D print first the piece, and then using this to guide myself on doing the bends and the cutting, and then the silver soldering. Also, I use a copper wire to do the details where the wires are going to be attached. And then at the end, I'm going to do electroplating to change the color brass to silver one. So don't miss that video. For the cabin hatch, I'm going to use this mold. I'm going to cast a fiberglass piece that is going to sit here. And also I'm going to use acrylic to create the windows or piece of glass here in this part. And this will be detachable to have access to the engine and to the batteries. Let's check some rigging hardware that I have built. These are the turnbuckles. I made this using some screw number 4, this one here, and 1/4 aluminum rod. I created a hole and treated it here, and then with some aluminum sheet, I create this piece here. That is the one that is going to be connected to the hole. And this hook here is going to be where the wire is going to be connected. This is a hardware for the boom. It's a gusset. It's the part that connects the boom with the mast. And to build this part, I use some aluminum L-shape and C-shape that you see here. And with some aluminum soldering rod and my rotary tool, I did all this work until reaching this result. This was my first attempt to build a band. Suppose that this is the mast and this is the boom. This is the piece that maintains in place the boom with the correct angle. So I made this one, I 3D print this one, and put some steel rod inside. But the thing that I don't like about this design is that I cannot vary the length of this one. So I'm planning to use to make a second one using this brass rod, this washer, this tool, and this one here. So let's see if the second design will work better.
And now this is a new band assembly that I just made. So this part goes here. And I can adjust the length of this by turning this one here. And also notice that if this one is fit, it can turn and adjust the length. And that's it.
I recently have invested a new camera for documenting this project, and I hope that you guys are enjoying the progress so far for this boat. If that is true, give me a thumbs up. If you would like to support more content like this or different projects in the future, please subscribe to the channel. For the next video, I will be working on the deck, specifically on the hatch for the cabin, and also probably on the mast, because I want to test the control sails before joining the deck and the hull together. So hopefully for the next video, see you there. Thank you for watching.